Our next speaker is going to be Ted Lozier from Ohio Division of Soil and Water. Ted.
Thank you, Director. I'm with the Ohio Department of Natural Resources, and I have one of my staff here, Fred Hammond. He's our program manager for the Soil and Water Conservation Districts. So, Fred, you may get some questions later on to help me with. And what I want to talk to you about a little bit is some additional stats just to impress upon us. I mean, we all know we're in very unusual conditions, but I just want to stress that they are extremely unusual conditions. And then I want to talk a little bit related to what Terry just talked about with regards to liquid manure storage. And we're working on a proposal to see if we can help out. I'll talk about that a little bit. Within our division, we have what we call a water inventory and planning program, and every month we put out a water inventory report. I brought several of those over here on the table. You could grab one on the way out. But within that, some of the stats, this has been the wettest April in 129 years of record. And the last record was set back in 1893. So that just gives you an idea of what we're dealing with here. And not only was it broke, but it was broke by a lot. The record in 1893 was 6.37 inches statewide. This April was 7.7 inches statewide, 4.12 inches above normal. And then in addition to that, both in April and May, over 50%, approaching 70% of all the days in April and May had received measurable quantities of precipitation. So there hasn't been any time for anything to dry out. It's just been constantly raining, as everyone knows that. And another stat, several of our reporting locations, within the last 3 months, they've already received half of their normal annual precipitation. We have some preliminary numbers for the month of May. Statewide, we're at 170% of normal. We still have a few more days to go, and that does not count the rains that occurred last night. With it across the 10 climatic regions that the state's divided up into, it ranges from 126% of normal to a high of 209% of normal. That's for the month of May to date, or actually up through yesterday, not counting yesterday's rain. The months of February through April, it's been the wettest period on record, 129 years of record. April received 215% above normal. March was roughly 150% of normal. And February was 205% of normal. So all that, of course, adds up to our stream flows. They're off the charts. And I mean literally, they're off the charts. When we pull the monthly water inventory report, our page isn't big enough to mark how high the stream flow is compared to normal. Our groundwater levels currently are near normal to slightly above normal. And our reservoirs, same, near normal to above normal. And Lake Erie rose roughly a half an inch in this past month, or the month of April. And it's approaching near long-term normal conditions. So all that to say, we are in extremely unusual conditions. So Director Zarin, thank you for pulling this group together. And I do want to mention that because of the manure storage, of all this rain, these storage lagoons are getting full and they can't get on the fields. Not only can they not get on the fields, but the additional rainfall, even though it may be raining directly on those, they're filling up. So what we're working on, and it is preliminary at this point, we should have some details out in the next couple of days, that we're going to provide cooperative assistance in hauling liquid manure to either a treatment facility that can treat the waste and or take it to another location that maybe has excess capacity, or to an area that maybe where it can't be spread. It's not a lot of money, but we've able to cobble together some dollars to help out this situation. And probably within the next couple of days, we'll have that formalized and get that out. We'll be working in cooperation with all the 88 soil water conservation districts to make that happen. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Ted. And then the information that you're going to make available, Andy will be able to have that on ODA's website also. Thank you very much. And farmers are getting very creative, going to abandoned facilities that have manure storage or wastewater treatment plants, and there's just other ways that we can handle that problem we have right now.